enters like this. Light enters at an angle of incidence in a transparent rod of refractive index n. So this is a transparent rod of refractive index, let's say n. For what value of refractive index of the material of the rod, the light once entered into it will not leave it through its lateral face, the upper and lower face, whatsoever be the angle of incidence. Now see, suppose light enters here like this and then this. Now minimum value of this angle must be greater than theta minimum, must be greater than critical angle. क्योंकि ये एंगल क्रिटिकल एंगल से बड़ा होगा तभी टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन होगा और तभी लाइट रेज लैटरल सरफेस से बाहर नहीं निकलेंगी. इस एंगल, इस ट्रायंगल में देखिए, इस एंगल और इस एंगल का सम हमेशा 90 डिग्री है. व्हेन दिस इज थीटा, दिस एंगल इज पाई बाय 2 माइनस थीटा. देयरफॉर व्हेन थीटा इज मिनिमम, दिस एंगल मस्ट बी मैक्सिमम, क्योंकि इन दोनों का सम कांस्टेंट है. सो इन दोनों का सम कांस्टेंट है तो इनमें से अगर एक सबसे छोटा होगा तो दूसरा सबसे बड़ा होना चाहिए. एंड व्हेन दिस एंगल इज मैक्सिमम, दिस हैज टू बी मैक्सिमम. मैक्सिमम वैल्यू ऑफ दिस एंगल इज 90 डिग्री. लेट से दिस एंगल इज फाई, सो फाई मैक्सिमम इज 90 डिग्री. व्हेन दिस इज मैक्सिमम दैट इज 90 डिग्री, दिस एंगल विल बिकम क्रिटिकल एंगल. And when this is critical angle, this theta will become pi by 2 minus c. And then pi by 2 minus c, which is the least value of theta, must be greater than c. That means pi by 2 must be greater than 2c. That means c must be less than pi by 4. Or sin c must be less than sin pi by 4, that is 1 by root 2. Sin c is 1 by mu. Therefore, mu must be greater than root 2. So, refractive index, or let's say here, the refractive index is n, n must be greater than root 2. So, our answer is root 2. The answer is A. For question number 25, the answer is A. Now, question number 26. A lens has focal length f. If half of the body of the lens is covered with black paper, the image produced by the lens will. Now, see, each part of a lens, if the lens is cut perpendicular to its face, each part of the lens behaves as a complete lens and follows all rules of refraction. Only thing happens is the amount of light passing through it is reduced. So intensity of the image is reduced. Otherwise, the size and nature of the image doesn't change. Therefore, when half of the lens is covered, the image produced A will disappear, wrong, B remains almost unaffected, C have its size reduced to half, wrong, D have its intensity reduced to half. D is most appropriate answer. B may, it remains almost unaffected means size and nature will remain unaffected, but its intensity will be reduced. So most appropriate answer in question number 26 is D. Because half of the light, half the lens is covered, so only half of the light will pass through the lens. Therefore, intensity of the image will be halved. This is question number 26. Now, question number 27. A lens behaves as a converging lens in air and a diverging lens in water. The refractive index of the material is, now A lens behaves as a converging lens in air. So the lens is converging in air, and lens when submerged in water behaves as diverging lens. That is possible only when refractive index of water is greater than the refractive index of medium of the lens. That means mu lens must be less than mu water. क्योंकि जब किसी लेंस को किसी लिक्विड में सबमर्ज करते हैं और उसका नेचर पलट जाता है, तो वो तभी होता है जब लेंस के मीडियम का रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स लिक्विड के रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स से कम होता है. इसका मतलब ये है कि लेंस के मीडियम का रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ग्रेटर देन वन यानी कि एयर एंड मस्ट बी लेस देन रिफ्रैक्टिव इंडेक्स ऑफ वाटर. दैट इज म्यू वाटर इज 4/3, 1.33. सो म्यू लेंस मस्ट बी ग्रेटर देन वन and must be less than 1.33. So the answer is C. It is between 1 and 1.33. So question number 27, the answer is C. Now question number 28. A lens shown in figure made of two different materials. A point object is placed on the axis. How many images of the object will the lens form? Now, question number 28 mein dekhe. Although there are too many parts of the lens, but there are only two media. So this lens will behave as basically two different lenses, because we are having two different media present. And therefore, the refraction will be like refraction from the two lenses. So there will be two distinct images formed. The answer is B. So question number 28, the answer is B. Now question number 29. A converging lens is used to form the image of an object on a screen. When the upper half of the lens is covered by an opaque screen, you know, when half of the lens is covered, half of the light will pass through the lens. Therefore, A, half the image will disappear. Wrong. B, complete image will be formed with unchanged intensity. Wrong. C, complete image will be formed by increased intensity. Wrong. D, complete image will be formed by decreased intensity. In fact, it is half the intensity. Therefore, question number 29, the answer is D. The size and nature of the image remains same, and the intensity is decreased to almost half. Now, question number 30. Question number 30 goes like this. An equi-convex lens of glass of focal length 0.1 meter is cut along a plane perpendicular to principal axis into two equal parts. The ratio of focal length of the new lens formed and original lens is. Now see, when we cut lens by this plane, we have two identical lenses whose power is reduced by half. Therefore, focal length power becomes P by 2. Therefore, focal length becomes 2F. So, final focal length of one part divided by focal length of the initial lens is 2. So, the answer is 2:1. The answer is C. Question number 30, the answer is C. Now question number 31. A convex lens of focal length F produces virtual image n times the size of the object. Then the distance of the object from the lens is. Question number 31 dekhe. A convex lens of focal length F produces a virtual image. Convex lens produces virtual image, means on the same side, n times the size of the object. So if this is the object, this is the image, so if this is x, this has to be nx, and for sign convention both are negative. Focal length of the convex lens is f. Now distance of the object from the lenses, we have to find out the value of x. Apply lens formula. Lens formula is 1 upon f is 1 upon v plus 1 upon u. Now 1 upon f is 1 upon v, v is nx, rather, sorry, lens formula mein there is a minus sign, and minus 1 upon u, u becomes minus x. So this will become 1 upon f is 1 upon x minus 1 upon nx, and that will become nx. Now n minus 1, therefore nx is n minus 1 times f, or x is simply n minus 1 times f divided by n. So the answer is C, n minus 1 divided by n times f. So question number 31, the answer is C. Now question number 32. Two thin lenses of focal length f1 and f2 are in contact and coaxial. The combination is equivalent to a single lens of power. Now, contact mein rakhe hue lenses ke liye, power is directly added. So, question number 32, equivalent power is simply P1 plus P2. P1 is 1 upon f1. P2 is 1 upon F2, so that will become F1, F2, F2 plus F1. So equivalent power of the combination becomes F1 plus F2 divided by F1, F2. And therefore, the answer becomes D, F1 plus F2 divided by F1, F2. Then question number 33. A glass prism deviates the red and blue rays through 10 degree and 12 degree respectively. A second prism of equal angle deviates them through 8 degree and 10 degrees respectively. Their dispersive powers are in the ratio. Now, dispersive power of a medium, of the prism, is defined as angle of dispersion divided by angle of deviation for mean color. Now here in for first prism, delta V is 12 and delta R is 10. So delta mean will become 11. Therefore, omega 1 will become 12 minus 10, that is capital delta, divided by 11, that is 2 by 11. Similarly, for second, delta V is 10, delta R is 8, so delta mean will become 9. Omega 2 is delta V minus delta R, that is 2 by 9. So ratio omega 1 by omega 2 becomes 2 by 11 divided by 2 by 9, that will become 9 by 11. So the answer is B, 9 is to 11 for question number 33. Then question number 34, dekhe. A ray of light incident normally on the first face of an equilateral prism undergoes total internal reflection at the second face. If refractive index is mu, then mu is, we have to find out mu. Now let's see the situation. There is a prism and a ray of light incident normally on the first face of an equilateral prism. So first of all, this angle is pi by 3, 60 degree. Normally incident hai ek face par. So पहले फेज पर तो लाइट विल पास विदाउट एनी रिफ्रैक्शन. नाउ ऑन द सेकेंड फेज दिस इज नॉर्मल, दिस इज 60 डिग्री, दिस इज 90 डिग्री, दिस इज 30, देयरफॉर दिस इज अगेन 60. नाउ दे से देयर इज अ टोटल इंटरनल रिफ्लेक्शन हियर, दैट मीन्स पाई बाय 3 मस्ट बी ग्रेटर देन क्रिटिकल एंगल. दैट मीन्स साइन सी इज लेस देन 60 डिग्री पाई बाय 3. साइन सी इज 1/μ, सो साइन सी is less than sin pi by 3 is sin 60 is root 3/2. That means sin c is 1/μ. 1/μ is less than root 3/2. So mu has to be greater than, isko palat diye, this will become 2/√3. So the mu has to be greater than 2/√3. The answer is D. So question number 34, the answer is D. Now inequalities solve karte samay thoda sa dhyan rakhna hai. Whenever you reciprocate, you have to just change the inequality also. So the answer is D. It has to be more than 2/√3. Now question number 35. The angle of a prism is 30 degree. The rays incident at 60 degree at one refracting phase suffer a deviation of 30 degree, then the angle of emergence is. Now for a prism, we know that the angle of deviation delta is I plus E minus A. I is angle of incidence, E is angle of emergence, and A is prism angle. The angle of prism is 30 degree, so A is 30 degree. The rays are incident at 60 degree, I is 60 degree. At one phase, suffer a deviation of 30 degree, delta is 30 degree. So 30 is equal to 60 plus E minus 30. That means 30 is equal to 30 plus E. So E will become 0. That means the angle of emergence becomes 0 degree. 0 degree means the rays will emerge out as the perpendicular to the surface, somewhat like this. So the answer is A for question number 35. The answer is A. Now prism ke question solve karne ke liye ek to important relation ye hai, dusra mu is equal to sine delta m plus a by 2 divided by sine a by 2, and of course delta is equal to a times mu minus 1. So we'll be able to solve these problems with the help of these given relations. This is question number 35. So let us talk about question number 36 now. It goes like this. Two plane mirrors are inclined to one another at an angle theta. The incident ray on mirror M1 is parallel to mirror M2. The reflected ray from M1 undergoes reflection at mirror M2. The final reflected ray is parallel to mirror M1. Angle theta is. Now maybe the two mirrors are like this. The incident ray on mirror M1 is parallel to mirror M2. So let's say it is M1, this is M2. Now ray incident on M1 is parallel to M2, and then the reflected ray from M1 undergoes reflection at M2, and after reflection it becomes parallel once again to the mirror M1. So in this case, you see total deviation suffered by the incident ray after reflection from both the mirrors is this. Now, for a two-plane mirror system inclined at an angle theta, the total angle of deviation is given by twice of pi minus theta. This is a matter of rule for the system of two-plane mirrors, where theta is the angle between the two mirrors. Now here, since this is parallel to this mirror and this is parallel to this mirror, therefore this angle is theta, and of course this angle is pi. So if we write it like this, delta is equal to pi plus theta, that is 2 pi minus 2 theta. It will make it like this: 3 theta is pi, or theta is pi by 3, that is 60 degree. So the angle between the two mirrors is 60 degree. The answer is C. Now, question number 37. Again, it has the same relation to use. Two plane mirrors are inclined to one another at an angle of 50 degree. A ray is incident on mirror M1 at an angle I, as shown in figure. The reflected ray from mirror M2 is parallel to M1. The angle of incidence I is. Now again, let us draw the similar kind of system. We have two mirrors and the angle of inclination is already given, 50 degree. Now, a ray is incident on mirror M1. Let us say this is M1 and this is angle of incidence. Now, the reflected ray from mirror M2, so this ray will reach M2 and then from M2 it will be reflected like this. Reflected ray from M2 is parallel to M1, so this is parallel to this. In this particular situation, this angle will become pi by 2 minus I, or ye I hai, that is how, chuki ye dono parallel hai, therefore these are corresponding angles, so pi by 2 minus I. So in this case, total deviation suffered by the light rays, that will become pi plus pi by 2 minus I. Now, total deviation suffered by light ray in a system of two parallel mirrors becomes twice of pi minus theta, and theta is given 50 degree. So that will become 2 pi minus 100. So if we equate it, it is 3 pi by 2 minus I is 2 pi minus 100. Now, 3 pi by 2, 2 pi minus is separate kariye, pi by 2, that is 90. Then minus I is 90 minus 100, or I is simply 10 degrees. Therefore, the answer is B. Sorry, the answer is D, 10 degrees. So this was question number 37. Now 38. A convergent beam of light is incident on a convex mirror of radius of curvature 24 centimeter, as shown in figure. Let us draw the figure. So 38, there is a convex mirror and there is a convergent beam of light incident on it like this. Radius of curvature of the mirror is given 24 centimeter. That means focal length is 12 centimeter. The image formed by the convex mirror is, this point of convergence is given 60 centimeters from the mirror. In this particular situation, we have to just apply UVF formula for the mirror. 1 upon F is 1 upon V plus 1 upon U. Now, since all the distances are measured in this direction, which is a positive direction, and it is a convex mirror, therefore focal length is also positive. So in that case, 1 upon 12 is 1 upon V. We have to calculate that, where these rays meet, plus 1 upon U. U is 60 centimeters. So 1 upon V comes out to be 1 by 12 minus 1 by 60. That is 5 minus 60. That is 1. 4 by 60. So V is 15 centimeter. The image will be found behind the mirror. Therefore, it is virtual. So image is virtual, and at the same time it is 15 centimeter behind the mirror. So answer is A. For question number 38, the answer is A. Now question number 39. A light ray incident normally on a plane mirror surface suffers a deviation of. Now, if the ray is incident normally on the plane mirror, of course, it will be reflected back in the same direction, and that means the ray which was coming like this is going like this. So, angle of deviation suffered by light ray is pi, that is 180 degree, and therefore the answer is C. Question number 39, the answer is C. Then question number 40 goes like this. A plane mirror is kept at the bottom of a tank containing a liquid of refractive index mu. P is a small object at a height h above the mirror. An observer O vertically above P outside the liquid sees P and its image in the mirror. The apparent distance between the two will be. Now, in a liquid of refractive index mu, the bottom is mirror surfaced and this distance is given h. Here, above liquid, one sees like this. So actually he will see two objects, one the object and the other its image in the mirror, and these two will be separated by a distance 2h inside the liquid. And when you look from air into the liquid of refractive index mu, the apparent depth is real depth divided by mu. So distance apparent between these two is simply 2h by mu, and the answer is B. So question number 40, the answer is B. Now question number 41, a dentist has a small mirror, actually dentists use concave mirror so that they can have proper magnification. So a dentist has a small mirror of focal length 16 centimeter. He views a cavity in the tooth of a patient by holding the mirror at a distance of 8 mm from the cavity. The magnification is, now listen, the concave mirror of focal length 16 mm and 8 mm is the distance from cavity. Now 1 upon F is 1 upon V plus 1 upon U. U is 8 mm. So 1 upon V is 1 upon 16 and then minus 1 upon 8. 8 is negative because this direction is positive direction. You are measuring this way. So this will become plus 8. That is 16 minus 1 plus 2, and that will be 1 by 16. So V is 16 mm. So the magnification M, which is V by U, will become minus 16 divided by minus 8, will make it 2. The answer is B. So for question number 41, the answer is B. Now question number 42, dekhe. The focal length of a concave mirror is F and the distance of the object from the principal focus is P. Then the ratio of the size of the image to the size of object is. Now in question number 42, in front of a concave mirror, an object is placed at a distance P from the principal focus. This is P. Therefore, U will become F plus P, and of course with minus sign because this is the positive direction, and F being for concave mirror negative, let us apply UVF formula. 1 upon F is 1 upon V plus 1 upon U, U is negative, 1 upon F plus P. So 1 upon V is 1 upon F plus P minus 1 upon F. 1 upon V will become F into F plus P, F minus F minus P, that is minus P by F into F plus P. So V will become F into F plus P divided by P with minus sign. Now we have to find out V by U in this particular question. V is F into F plus P divided by P, if we lose the sign, only length of the object, and that divided by the distance of object F plus P. So the ratio of image length and object length comes out to be F by P. The answer is A. So for question number 42, the answer is A. Now in question number 43, a point object O is placed between two plane mirrors as shown in figure. Now let us show you the figure. In question number 43, we have two plane mirrors separated by 10 mm and the mirrors are M1 and M2. 2 mm is the distance of a point from mirror M2. Now, the distance of first three images formed by mirror M2 from it are. So first image formed by M2 is the image of the object that is this. That will be 2 mm only. So in all the answers, this is 2 mm. Second image of the object will be formed by M2 for the mirror M1. So for M1, it is 8 mm. Therefore, its image formed will be 8 mm behind the mirror M1. M2 will form image of this. And therefore, this distance, which is 18 mm, the image formed by the second mirror M2 for this object will be at 18 mm. So, answer can be from B, C and D only. And now, the third image, when this is 18, this is 10, that will become 28. So, this mirror will form another image of the object at a distance 28 mm behind the mirror M1. So, the third image formed by M2 will be of an object 38 mm from it. So, the new distance will become 38 mm for the third image. So, the answer is C. It is 2 mm and then 18 mm and then third is 38 mm. So we got the three answers for question number 43. Then question number 44 says, one cannot see through fog because actually fog consists of tiny droplets of water suspended in air. So when light falls on it, the light is scattered in all possible directions, and therefore it cannot be focused at your retina. So the answer B is correct for question number 44. It says the light is scattered by the droplets of fog. Now question number 45. Question number 45 goes like this. A stationary swimmer S inside a liquid of refractive index mu 1 is at a distance D from the fixed point O. So question number 45 dekhe. There is a stationary swimmer S from a fixed point O at a distance D. Now a rectangular box of width T and refractive index mu 2. Mu 1 is the refractive index of the liquid. Now placed between S and O, S will observe O to be at. Now listen, for this box, the apparent depth as seen from this liquid, iske liye iska refractive index ho jayega, actually mu 2 by mu 1. Now apparent depth, real depth upon apparent depth is refractive index of this with respect to this. So real depth T upon apparent depth T apparent. So T apparent will become T into mu 1 by mu 2. Now the distance as seen by swimmer will become basically D minus T plus T apparent. That is D minus T plus T apparent is T into mu 1 by mu 2. That is D minus T common 1 minus mu 1 by mu 2. So let us match the answer. The answer is B. D minus T bracket mein 1 minus mu 1 by mu 2. This is question number 45. Now question number 46. 46 goes like this. A thin prism P1 with angle 4 degree and made from glass of refractive index 1.54 is combined with another prism P2 made from glass of refractive index 1.72 to produce dispersion without deviation. The angle of prism P2 is. Now, when two prisms are combined, either for dispersion without deviation or for deviation without dispersion, they are combined like this. Now, angle of one prism is given 4 degrees. Angle of second prism is theta, let's say. Now, we want to combine the two prisms for dispersion without deviation. We want delta to be 0. Delta is delta 1 plus delta 2, and that we want 0. This is possible only when one delta is equal to other delta and opposite of sign. Opposite sign is ensured by reversed prism. Otherwise, delta 1 has to be equal to delta 2. Delta is A times mu minus 1. The refractive index of first prism is given 1.54, whereas the other is given 1.72. So 4 into 1.54 minus 1. That is delta 1. That must be equal to theta into 1.72 minus 1. 0.54 into 4 is 0.72 into theta. Now 18, 3 is 54, 4 is 72. So theta is 3 degrees. The angle of the second prism must be equal to 3 degrees. So the answer is C. Question number 46, the answer is C. Then question number 47 goes like this. The minimum magnifying power of a telescope is capital M. If the focal length of its eye lens is halved, the magnifying power will become. Now listen. Telescope ki minimum magnifying power is given by minus FO by FE. Now in this case, if FE is halved, so 2 will go up and the M dash will become 2M. 2M means the answer is B. So question number 47, this is the formula for magnification, and FE ko half karne par, you'll get the magnification 2M, the answer is B. Now question number 48. A terrestrial telescope is made by introducing and erecting lens of focal length F between the objective and the eye lens of an astronomical telescope. This causes the length of the telescope tube to increase by an amount equal to. Now, what erecting lens does is it just makes image of the object of same height but erect. So for that, this has to be 2f, and of course this will also become 2f. So rest of the optics of entire telescope remains same. The only thing is that this extra distance is introduced, and that is simply 4f. So answer is D. Now question number 49. The tube length of a microscope is 10 cm and the focal length of its objective is 5 cm. If the eye lens has focal length of 0.5 cm, then the magnification of the microscope for relaxed eyes is. Now see, for microscope, the formula for magnification is given like this. M is minus VO by UO into D by FE, 1 plus FE by VE. This is for magnification for a microscope. Now for relaxed eyes, VE is infinity. When you put VE infinity, M will become minus VO by UO into D by FE. Now, FE is given 0.5 and tube length is given. The 10 centimeters. So if we suppose consider this is objective, this is eyepiece, final image is formed at infinity. Therefore, first image formed by objective lens must be at the focal length of the eyepiece. Focal length of the eyepiece is given 0.5. Total tube length is given 10 centimeters. So this is 19.5 centimeters. Now, VO is given to us. We have to find out UO. 1 upon FO. FO is given 5 centimeters. Is 1 upon VO. Minus 1 upon UO. UO is negative, so let us find out the numerical value of UO. 1 upon UO will become 1 upon 5 minus 1 upon 19.5. If we take LCM, 195, this is 19, let us find out. 39 minus, this will become what? 10. 29. Let us take it here somewhere. So 1 upon u becomes 1 upon 5 minus 1 upon 19.5, and this will become the 5 into 19.5. 19.5 minus 5 will become what? 14.5. And then it is 29. Now, from this, UO comes out to be this. Isko yahan pa dal diye. VO by UO will become, VO aa gaya aapka 195. That is 195 divided by 29. Into D is 25 divided by FE is given. IP इसकी फुकल लेंदे रखी है 0.5, सो रफली से 30 मान लें, द आंसर विल कम आउट टू बी आफ्टर कैलकुलेशंस 45, सो द आंसर इज सी. एंड फाइनली क्वेश्चन नंबर 50, द मैग्निफिकेशन प्रोड्यूस्ड बाय द ऑब्जेक्टिव लेंस एंड द आई लेंस ऑफ ए कंपाउंड माइक्रोस्कोप आर 25 एंड 6. The magnifying power of this microscope is, so microscope के लिए magnification में एक और formula defined है, total magnification of the microscope is equal to m transverse of objective into m theta of eyepiece, that is given 25 and 6, that will become 150. So question number 50, the answer is C. You try out these questions once again and you'll see that these questions are easy and you can build up your concepts.